working on my climb to Vail, top of Vail Pass. So 36 degrees. There's still snow. I think they're still snowing or still skiing down there at Vail. They look like a ski jump set up. But yeah, so actually going a little bit quicker than I was. I was down to 30 mile an hour. Now I'm up to 37 mile an hour. But I think it gets a little steeper up here. But I thought I'd just throw this in, showing that I don't even know what the pass is up here. There's still snow. Well, I wouldn't say there was no snow at the Vail. So anyway, I'll make a note of the summit up here. So, coming up on Vail Pass. Sitting up here. That's why you're looking at the steering wheel right now. All right, Vail Pass summit is 10,603 feet. I got 48 minutes. There was the Vail Pass that I could have stopped at, but there's a rest area and there's Frisco. I don't know about anything else after that. So, Frisco, I think, is it. Hopefully there's room. Later, guys. Trailer, one of those pups. up trailers. Okay, we're down to 30 now. Now I've had my V8 juice this morning. Woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Oh, well, actually, no, we're up. Woke up on the right side of the bed with the eyelid inverted again. I don't know what made me do it. I took some water and soaked a washcloth and laid that on top. That would make it bigger. So then I fell back to sleep, not with the washcloth on my face. Took care of that. Put all that away. Fell back to sleep and then woke up again. Hey, wait, I got an ice pack. Grabbed the ice pack and wrapped it in a paper towel and then tried to stick that on my eye, and that's kind of hard to do. I think it helped a little bit because I couldn't open my eye at all. First or second time, my eyelid, I should say. And then, see, it beat me again. What the hell? There's a sensor right there. Huh. And then, yeah, the ice pack helped, but I think it, contracted the swelling just a bit so I can open my eye there. Guess I'm going to have to either get me a sleep mask or an eye patch at night. Because I lay on the left side. If I lay on my right side, my right eardrum leaks fluid. And we're down to 29 mile an hour in seventh gear. Although it just shifted up again. I don't know why. I will be home today. For at least a few hours later. A few hours in the morning, then get up. Hopefully have enough time to do the laundry and work on the layout, maybe. See what I need for the NCO layout and hook it all up. I mean, it's all hooked up. I need a few more track pieces. I want to skew the plan a bit. Instead of having a 90-degree turn, I'm just see if I can put some turns at the beginning and ends and make it a little more like a 45 throughout. I might put up a 45 piece of maybe even something wider, 60 degrees across the 90-degree corner. Flatten it out a bit, make it, have it look like it's going through a 45-degree angle instead of a 90-degree angle. night, or I should say this morning. I woke up and freeze my butt off. Got dressed and then started the truck, put everything on, coat included, until the truck warmed up. Put it on fast idle a little bit, about 1100 or so, so try to heat up quicker, and then took the coat off and slept in my clothes. What happened? I saw a truck. I did see a truck. Getting a little bit faster than I am. CFI. Or Dillon. I was at Frisco. Dillon was over the next one. Dillon Silverthorne. This probably would have turned into about a 12-minute climb for about 5 miles. Is it 5 miles, I think? I need a downshift. Faster than me. Now what are you doing? Stupid. I better not be overhyped. I'm a piss. Be pissy. I have to go 6 and I don't want to do 6. I'm under. There's no way in hell I'm over. 13.6. I think the light back there would have flashed me and told me I was over 13.11. Now, if I didn't hit the tunnel and I didn't hit that, then I'm okay. See the tunnel, do you? Now this isn't even a straight tunnel. It's definitely not like Hanging Lake tunnel. That thing turned, what, turned left, and turned right, and back left again? And a nice, gentle S-curve. Something us model railroaders don't like is S-curves. But it was gentle enough. I bet a train could go through it, if it'd be tall enough. Freaking people out. See, this makes a turn to the left. Well, it turns right a bit, then it turns left. Brakes! That's not good. Is it slick? Better not be. Ooh. pits are coming out. He's still on his brakes. Be back later. I was sitting here at Silver Plume, thought I'd stop and take pictures of the old equipment sitting here and their historic railroad that they use over here on Georgetown Loop. They blocked the what the hell? Hang on.